When we think of rivers, we tend to think of single channels, deep in the middle, shallow on the outside. And that's what most rivers are like. But there are many systems in the world that are a lot more complicated and they're ecologically interesting. So that's what I'm going to talk about today. And I'm here at the River Feshie in Cairngorm in Scotland. And this is one such complicated river. And what's its origin? Well, the key issue is that these, surrounded by these stunning mountains here, and these are clearly of glacial origin. And there are screes on the outside, so there's lots of stones, lots of rocks. And because they're those mountains, there will be pulses of high water. So there'll be high rain, this is a wet part of the world, and there'll be snow that then melts, and then that meltwater will then flow off the mountains. And those pulses of high water will then bring those rocks down into this system, making this full of large sediment. So what then happens? Imagine that we have a single channel here, and then in the middle, it's fast and it's deep, and that's where the largest bits of sediment will be carried. But then it slows down, perhaps it gets a bit wider or flatter or something, and then the current will drop and the sediment will be dropped out. So you'll have large rocks or boulders dropped in the middle of the system, and then because of that, the current will slow further, and then other rocks will then be deposited. And so you'll have a pile of rocks, and then downstream of that, you'll have more and more rocks accumulating. And this is a dynamic system, so there'll also be erosion. So erosion from the top will be pushing it, but it'll be carried and eroded from the sides as rocks go down. And this bar, what is called a braid bar, will just travel downstream. So we have a system where bars are created in the middle of currents, and then you have two streams now. You have one here, there'll be one on the far side, but it'll also be one on this side. And you can see here, as this moves, it then cuts into this side of the bank, which is also full of rocks, and it's clearly eroding it away. At times of high water, it will erode these rocks away, and it will push the river sideways, and it'll widen the river. So rather than a single channel, you have multiple channels, and you have a wide system. It's quite hard to see here, but actually there's a channel that goes off here, around the side of, there's an island there. There's a couple of channels there. There's a big channel that goes around the back, around there. So there's a whole complex, interconnected set of water, flowing water bodies. And this is called a braided river because it looks like the braid of threads, the intertwined threads of a braid. And so you get braided rivers where you have pulses of water, where you have a rocky system, where you have banks that can be eroded, where it's steep and the water is fast moving. In the lowlands, you have what looks like the very similar system, where there are these interconnected channels, what are called anastomosed rivers. But actually, they're completely different. They are caused by erosion going through the floodplain, and the river goes through the floodplain and it erodes out a whole series of different channels, creating this complex mesh which split and then come back together again. So anastomosed rivers are completely different for two reasons. Firstly, they're caused by erosion. Braided rivers are largely caused by deposition. And secondly, this system here, the braided rivers, is highly dynamic. The anastomosed rivers, once they have eroded and created, they tend to be reasonably stable and fixed. So rivers can have very complicated patterns and can be very dynamic. And of course, because of that, they have very interesting ecologies.